Good day, fellow investors. Now, last month, free stocks I'm buying was a complete success. Amira Nature Foods is up, Nevsun is up, and I think also Store is a bit up. So please check that video. I still think those are very strong buys. Now, not to repeat myself, I decided to make a new video with new interesting stock picks. But before that, in order again not to repeat myself, check the top three stocks we analyzed during July that I think are really, really good buys. Those are Norilsk Nickel, yesterday's video. Those are Gazprom, a little bit more risky, but still very interesting long-term play. And the Chinese company YY. So please check the videos and I'm sure you'll find interesting investment opportunities there for your risk-reward appetite and your portfolio. So let's start with the free stocks for August, to buy in August, which I think will do very well in the mid, short and long term. The first company is Whirlpool. So kitchen appliances and all that kind of boring stuff. It's cheap relative to market, it's growing and it has huge potential. The first potential comes from middle class expansion. As the middle class expansion accelerates, is expected to double in the next 15 years. And what does the middle class use? Kitchen appliances. Voila! And what better company than Whirlpool to take advantage of this long-term inevitable trend? What does the company do? Well, you probably know it from value within the set that they acquired in 2014 to higher branded appliances like KitchenAid. Annual growth is very significant and expected to grow in the future. What they're very focused is cost. Okay, steel prices went a bit down, so their EBIT margin is pretty high and improving. They have a global leading share position, top one US, top one Brazil, top one Italy, France, third in India, which is the top country to be exposed to the middle class boom. Number five in China, so very, very good global position to take advantage of the growth that's coming in global development and global middle class explosion. As I said, well positioned for India, China growth. Even if appliance demand in China has been suffering, it's still growing and sales for the company are expected to grow. Appliance penetration, so how many households have a kitchen appliance? For you, it's normal. Just 19% in India, just 42% in China. Expected annual growth year over year is 12% in India, 8% in China. So if you like dividends, Whirlpool is also a nice company for you. They are paying out, making more and more cash, growing. The acquisitions that they made have been very profitable and the dividend has doubled in the last 5 years and expected to double in the future because they are increasing it every year. On top of the dividend, they are doing share repurchases. I don't like them in the long term, but in this case, I see Whirlpool shooting up in the short term because they have just announced a 2 billion share repurchase program, which is 15% of the company. So that will lead to higher earnings, higher dividends per share, and pushing the stock price higher after the recent sell-off. So after the recent earnings, the stock price really dropped because they missed some estimates. Nevertheless, ongoing earnings are still positive. Everything looks pretty good for Whirlpool. You can just buy it cheaper. As you can see, Whirlpool is not immune to such drops. Similar thing happened in May, and those who bought in May did really well in the next 2 months. Look at valuations. Price earnings ratio current is 17.8. Forward with $15 per share of earnings, I see it at 12. Price to book is still below S&P 500. The dividend yield is 2.3% and expected to grow. If you add the buyback yield, then you are at a very, very nice yield. So Whirlpool, positive global trends, profitable company, filled with cash, 1 billion in free cash flow expected on 77 million shares, so that's $15 per share, which is a cash flow yield of 10%. Excellent returns on a stable company, currently cheap because the market thinks they missed some estimates. Steel prices are a little bit rising, but if you look at the long-term perspective, and if you look at from a perspective of the share buybacks that can really push the stock price higher because the company is going to buy 15% of itself. So the downside is limited and the upside is really, really strong. I see a price target of 225 in the next 6 to 12 months for Whirlpool. Second company I want to talk, and this is, now you'll say, oh boy, Sven, you're very old, but Skechers. Skechers is a very interesting company. It's not competing with the Cristiano Ronaldo's and Nike or NBA. It's just doing boring shoes for boring people, especially if you're a little bit overweight. Nevertheless, sales are growing and the stock price is still relatively cheap. Skechers was growing very fast in 2014-15. Euphoria was created, and then of course when there is euphoria, estimates go to the sky and the company is bound to miss them. Stock price dropped significantly, then recovered a bit, but the company continues to do well. If you look at revenue performance, more than doubled in the last 4 years, and it will pass 4 billion in 2017. Earnings per share have exploded in the last 4 years and will continue. Expected earnings per share in 2017 around $2 per share, leading to a price earnings ratio of around 12-13, which is very low when compared to companies like Nike for similar or even better growth. Let's see the growth. The CEO showed that second quarter net sales increased 16.9%. 16.9%, that's huge. So domestic sales increased 6.4%. That was the problem in the past quarters, that domestic sales are flat. Now also those have increased. International wholesale business sales have increased. So very, very positive. And they expect to hit 4 billion in revenues. They have $4.8 of cash per share. That's a good margin of safety. They can pay higher dividends, invest in what's going on. So that's very, very nice. Or be taken over. So also potential takeover target. The company is really growing. Their store base increased by around 15% from 2000 to 2,300 stores. So really growing. And the company is expected to grow more in the future, especially because it's exposed to China. My target, let's say earnings per share of $2.2 in 2017, price earnings ratio of 20, we are at $45 per share. So when the market sees it, when the market recognizes it, then the price will go up because it's really a growth company, global growth company. And I think the market misunderstands Skechers and what's going on. The third company I want to talk about is a strong brand that was just hit after earnings. So Starbucks is one of the global strongest brands. The company is still growing and expected to grow. It currently has 2,600 stores in China, expected to pass 5,000 by 2021. So huge market, huge potential, huge profitable potential. From a technical note, those brands, such strong brands, are always traded at a premium. So if you can catch them when they're cheap, it is great. You can see how Starbucks' stock is flat for a while, then jumps up, then it's flat, jumps up, flat, jumps up, flat. And now it has been flat for a while. So given that the company continues to grow, I see it that it's ready for a new jump. Why it will jump? Because revenue in Q3 grew 9%, margins grew, gross margins grew, everything, when you look at it from a fundamental business perspective, is really, really great. Now, if that is not enough, I don't know what should be enough. Let's finish with our table of the stocks we recommended last month. I still think them as a strong buy: Amphi, Nefsun, Starbucks, Whirlpool, and Skechers, also very good buys. And the target price, Starbucks 75 after the pop, Whirlpool 225, and Skechers 40-45. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy the stocks and you find interesting stocks in whatever we have been doing in the last month. Please share your comments below, ask your questions, share your ideas if you have interesting stock picks, leave them, leave your portfolio so that we can research and add value to our investing community. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.